morning, dear students, see you through your machine lab. Today we perform our third experiment. The aim of the third experiment is conduct experiment on universal Dorner operators and draw the graph between height and equilibrium speed of the Dorners. So what are the objective of this? The objective of this determination of a characteristic curve of the Dorner speed against the slip displacement, against the slip displacement. So we have already studied in the theory classes. The Dorner is the apparatus which is adjusted with the fuel quantity according to the speed variation of the engine. According to the speed variation of the engine, it adjusts the fuel quantity. If the load on the engine increases, it increases the quantity of the fuel. And if the load on the engine decreases, it decreases the quantity of fuel also. So, Dorner maintains the equilibrium speed of the engine. So, we have already discussed different types of the Dorners. As we discussed in the theory classes, there are first two types, main types, in the centrifugal and inertial Dorners. Centrifugal Dorner is the further classified into the simple pendulum type and the loaded weight type. In the simple pendulum type, there is the hot Dorner, and in the loaded type, there are the two loaded type Dorner. One is the spring loaded and one is the dead weight. In the dead weight category, there is the Porter Dorner, Prowl Dorners, or in case of the spring loaded Dorner, there is the Halter Dorner, Harton Dorners, so etc. So today in this experiment, we are discussing about the two main category, what that is the simple pendulum type and Porter Dorners. So this experiment, what types of the apparatus is the required? First one is the universal Dorner apparatus, second weight, third speed control device, and tachometers. Tachometer we use for the measuring the RPM of the Dorners. So what are the formulas used for this experiment? First, this is the use for the find the height of the Dorners. H naught is the initial height at the 0 RPM. What is the height of the Dorner? That is the H naught. X is the displacement of the sleeve. X is the displacement of the sleeve when there is the give the RPM from the engine. Alpha, we find the alpha using cos alpha H by L. There we are taking the alpha, this cos inverse H by L, and R, that is the radius of rotation, equals to 50 plus L by sine alpha. Force can be calculated as follow. There is the angular velocity omega, arm of the balls and arm about the spindle axis, that is equals to the 2 pi n by 60 in radian per second, and is the RPM of the spindle, that is the calculated with the help of the tachometers. After that we are finding the centrifugal force, because these are the centrifugal Dorners and their principle is the centrifugal force. Centrifugal force Fc calculated by W, weight of the ball, by G is the gravitational force, that is equal to 9.81 meter per second square. Omega square, omega is the angular velocity and R naught is the radius of rotation at the given RPM in kg. This force we find out of the kg. So there is the given data of the experimental setup. There is the given the length for the Porter Dorner and the Watt Dorner. Both are the length of the links are the same. That is equals to the 125 mm. Initial height of the Dorner H naught, that there is, we find out the next height, that is equals to the 94 mm. Initial radius of rotation, that is equals to the 136 mm. And weight of each ball is equals to the 0.35 kg. So dear students, these are the diagrams of the line diagrams of the Watt Dorners. So this is the pinpoint. The distance between the pinpoint is the 100. And this is the initial height, H naught. These are the balls, these are the links, and this is the sleeve axis. Now this is the angle alpha between the pivoted point and the ball links, that is equals to the alpha, and this is the radius of rotation of the ball, that is equals to the r. This data is given, L length of each link, these are each link is equal, that is equals to 125 mm. H, this initial height is equals to 94 mm. R, initial radius of rotation, that r naught 136 mm, and weight of each ball is equals to 0.35 kg. And this is the line diagram for the portal burner. The difference between the portal and the watt burner is there is adding with the sleeve weight, that is called the dead weight. We are adding the weight in the portal burner. We do not add the weight in the watt burner. So it is the centrifugal burner and this is the dead weight burner. Now we have come on the observation table. So dear students, this is our observation table. There is the serial number, speed, and speed of the burner in RPM that we calculated with the help of tachometer, and sleeve width x. That is the difference between the initial reading and the final readings. The we compute there. Okay. After these readings, we are calculating. This is the calculation tables. We are calculating sleeve width RPM from this table. We calculate the height of the sleeve. We are calculating the alpha. We are calculating the radius of rotation, and we are last calculating the centrifugal force in kg. This is over observation tables. Now come on the experimental setup and performing the experiment and finding with the in the experiment we are taking two readings: speed of the burner and sleeve length. So dear student, this is over the experimental setup. This is the universal burner. Okay, this is the DC motor speed control. This is the speed control device, tachometers, weight, dead weight for the portal burners. Okay, steel rod for measuring the sleeve lift. Okay, now we start. Oh, these are the balls. These are the links. The length is given 125 mm. Initial height from this center to up to this, initial height is given 94, and the initial radius of rotation also given. Okay, now there is the initial sleeve lift at the zero. We are marking at this point, and this is the tachometer using for the measuring the RPM of this governments. Now we start over the setup. First we are moving at the low speed. Okay, there is the no displacement, no sleeve lift. Now we increase the RPM with this speed control device. Increase the speed of the burner with this speed control device. And we take the readings. Now the sleeve is the lift. We are taking the readings with this tachometer. That is the rear board 160 RPM. Okay, so note on this reading 160 RPM in your notebook, and now calculate the sleeve lift. So we are taking from the marker, there is the sleeve lift equals to the 23 mm. So initial reading at the 160 rpm, sleep lift 23 mm. Okay, x equals to 23 mm, we made 2.3 cm. Okay, now we increase the rpm again. Now you can see this, we move upward. Now we count the rpm. Again we counting the rpm. That is equals to the 75 mm. So same way we are taking another reading with increasing the RPM. With increasing the RPM and again calculating the sleeve length. So this is the experiment procedure for the what. Now we next discuss the experimental procedure for the ward governor. So please shut down your power off. Okay. Dear students, now for the quarter governors, we are adding there the dead weight. Okay. That equals to the total weight is equals to the 1 kg. Now again we have same procedure follow for the quarter governor for taking the readings. Okay, first there is the nose sleeve update. Okay, at the low RPM we increase the RPM. Now sleeve start moving upward, sleeve starting lifting, and at this RPM that is equals to 200 RPM, and we see the sleeve lift. Now the sleeve lift is 30 mm. Sleeve lift is 30 mm at the 200 RPM. Now again we will increase the RPM more. So dear students, this is our observation table and these are our observations from the experiment. First observation, at the 160 RPM the sleeve lift is equals to 23 mm, at the 200 RPM sleeve lift equals to 75 mm, and at the 238 RPM sleeve lift equals to the 110 mm. From these observations we are calculating the height, angle alpha, radius of rotation and force. Now again the same values will be there, sleeve lift and speed of governor in RPM. We are calculating the height with this sleeve lift equals to the 82.5 mm. If the sleeve lift 75 mm, the height of the governor equals to the 56.5 mm. If the lift of the governor 110 mm, then the height of the governor equals to the So with increasing the RPM, okay, with increasing the sleeve lift, the height of lower is the decreasing. Now alpha first 48.7 degree, next 63.13 degree, 71.82 degree. Now radius of rotation at the 160 RPM and 23 sleeve and at this height equals to the 143.91 m. If the sleeve of lift 75 RPM increases, the radius of rotation is increases. At this RPM, also the radius of rotation of the increases. So with increasing the RPM of the burner, the radius of rotation is the increasing. And the force engaging also increases 1.44, 2.527 and 3.74. So this is over the calculation or observation from these two observations, speed and sleeve of the plate. Now we draw the plot between the speed and sleeve lift. So which type is the graph has come? We see from the, that is called the characteristic curve. So dear students, now we draw the graph between the RPM and the sleeve lift. So horizontal we take the sleeve lift and then the vertical we take in the RPMs. So at the 160 RPM, sleeve lift is equal to 23 MPa. 160. So dear, so this point is come at this point. Next at 200 RPM, 75. Now at the 230, the lift is the 110. So this is the characteristic curve between the sleeve, speed of the spindle and the sleeve lift. Okay, this is the speed of the spindle of the burner, sleeve of the burner and the sleeve lift. So this is the characteristic curve. Now we next plot, draw between the speed and the height of the burner. Next graph we draw between the speed and height of the burner. Okay dear students, now we draw the graph between the height of burner and RPM. So horizontal will take in the RPM and this will take in the height of the burner. At the low RPM, we see from the observation tables, at the observation table, the height of the burner at 160 RPM equals to the 82 at 160 RPM. At n is 160, height of burner 82. 2 point something. So this point has come at this place. At the RPM 200, the height of the burner is equal to the real burner of 56. That is point come at this place at the 256. And at the 238 RPM, the height of the burner equals to the 39. So, like this. So, this is the characteristic curve of the burner between the speed and the height of burner. So, from here we can see that if we increase the RPM, the height of the burner decreases. So, within this, your third experiment is the completed. Thank you.